Good morning, my dear and lovely students. My name is Kuldeep Singh, your English teacher. Today, my dear students of class 9, I will teach you a chapter from this book, Beehive, class 9. So I'll give you 15 seconds to take out your book. Mind it, my dear student, along with the book, you should have a pencil because I will tell you the meanings of the difficult words. And then you will write it down in your books, okay? Okay, my dear student. The chapter name is The Road Not Taken, class 9th. Book name is Beehive. Okay, so I will start with the chapter The Road Not Taken. Let's talk about the person who has written this wonderful, wonderful poem. The poem Road Not Taken was written by Robert Frost, one of the finest American poets. In this poem, when he was young, Robert Frost, so when you be young, you choose, here the road means the road not taken, the career that was not opted by the different people at their different age. Now, when we grow up at that level, then we have to take a decision. The meaning of this, the heading is the road not taken, the career that was not opted by Robert Frost. So that tells about the complete poem. The road here refers to or signifies here for life. Okay. This poem tells you about, again, we'll talk about choosing a career. So he is standing in the early morning through the forest. He is able to see. He comes on the road, and then he sees two roads are being diverged. One is being used by the people, that means the career that is being frequently used by the people, or the people, the students who opt to go on the following career. The other road was not being used much. So what his decision will be, what he will do, this is what is being told by Mr. Frost. Okay. So through the stanzas we will study, okay? The Road Not Taken, written by Robert Frost. This is well known poem that tells you about making choices, and the choices that shape us our future also. Robert Frost is an American poet who writes simply but insightfully about common ordinary experiences, okay? From line wise you will study, you should have a pencil in your hand, and I will tell you the meaning of the difficult words, okay? Stanza 1 will start with, first line, two roads diverge in a yellow wood. Two roads means choosing an option that will be fruitful or may not be fruitful in your future life. So you should be very precise in choosing a career, he says. Two roads, he said that he was able to see two roads, diverged means separated. The meaning of the word, you underline it, the meaning is separated, okay? In a yellow wood. Yellow refers to season of autumn also, or full of people. Write it down, please. Yellow wood refers to season of autumn. Or forest with decomposing leaves. There are different meanings for it. Yellow can also be referred as forest with decomposing leaves. So the meaning is two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Okay. Two roads, they were diverging and both were having yellow. Yellow refers to decomposing leaves. And sorry, I could not travel both. Then he says that he's not being a lonely traveler. He was alone, so he could only travel on single road. He cannot go on one road, and then it's not possible for him to return back, and then he can go on. He has to choose one road only, being a lonely travel. And sorry, I could not travel both. And he's asking pardon for it, and say, he's saying that I'll be able to use only one boat. Okay. And be one traveler. As I told you, he's only single traveler. Long I stood, and then he thought and thought and pondered which road he's supposed to go, and looked down as one as far as I could. And then he tried to look by his naked eyes how, what all the things that he was able to see on the road. Okay, then to where it bent in the undergrowth, and then he was able to see for some part, and then the road again diverged. Okay, undergrowth means dense growth of plants. Underline the word undergrowth and write dense growth of plants. So that completes your first stanza. He says two roads he was able to see in that yellow wood. Then, being a lonely traveler, he could only travel on one road. And then he was able, or he was wanting to see as far as he can see on one road. And then one road that he was looking for, then it bent. Okay, this is one road that they are talking about. Now, in the second stanza, my dear student, he will look for the second road that is not being used much by the people. Then he took the other, and then he started looking at the other road, just as fair. Now he was wanting to distinguish between the road, but both the roads looked as good. The meaning of the word fair, please you underline fair and then you write good. Both the road appeared to him as equally good, okay, and having perhaps the better claim. And meaning of the word perhaps is probably the better claim. He sees or he thinks that it is having a better option. The meaning of the word claim is better option. And he thought that second road is better than the first one that he looked for, okay, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Now that second road was not being used much by the people. My dear student, when we opt and we opt for a career, whatever we thought, okay, I'm using this career, many might have not been might have not used this road or this career. But it is not the way. When you go along and then you come to know that many people have already traveled on the road. From far it appeared that the first road was appearing that okay, many have used. But and then for the second road, he thought that this road is not being much used by the people. He was wrong, okay. Because it was grassy and wanted wear. Meaning of the word grassy and wanted wear means it was unused, not being used by many people, okay. Because when you see, when many people walk on the grass, okay, it wears down, the color of the grass changes. He was thinking like that the second road is not being used much by the people, but he was totally wrong in that. Because it was grassy and wanted wear and grassy, not used much, okay. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. Now it refers to the people who've already used this road. Using the road means using the career. Many people have already traveled on the second road also. Many have been successful, many have been a failure. Okay, depends upon. Okay, so this is the second stanza. Now we will move to the third one. And both that morning equally lay. Now he is standing there and looking which road he is supposed to go. In leaves, no step had trodden black. Trodden means walked over. And in the morning, both had the leaves were fallen on the road, and no one has traveled on that road on that particular morning. He will be the first one who will be traveling on the road. Maybe the first one or maybe the second one. Oh, I kept the first for another day. He said, now he will be choosing the second road rather than using the first one. He said that he will keep it for another day, but it's not possible because when you choose a career, you go on so much in that, and the age is also a factor. It's not possible for you to return back and choose another career, another road. No, it's not possible. Maybe some might be able to do it, but it requires a lot of courage. A lot of time also is being spent. So again, suggestion from Robert Foster is whenever you're wanting, you should choose where you should be very, very precise before choosing a road or a career. Okay. Oh, I kept the first for another day, he says, and then he uses exclamation mark. He knows that he may not be able to travel back again on the first road. He has to go on the second road. Okay. Yet knowing how a way leads on to a way. What happens when you choose one career, then you keep on moving in that. There are many things that may happen good or that may not happen good. But you cannot leave it. You have to keep on prolonging and persevering. Okay. I doubted that I should ever come back. No, he will not be able to come back. And this is being said by Robert Frost, that he may not be able to come back on that again, standing on that diverged road, and then he can come on, or he can go on the first road. It will not be possible. Okay. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Now he says, whatever decisions that you take at that early age will define your future. So he says, I shall be telling with a sigh. Sigh means deep breath. My dear student, deep breath refers to maybe choosing a good career, so that may be fruitful. So deep sigh, when you take long breath, that may say, okay, that he may be have been successful. That's why he's taking a deep breath, or he may not have been successful. So refers to both. Okay. Somewhere ages and ages hence. Hence means in the future. Please write down. Hence means in the future. So the meaning of the word sigh is a deep breath. Two roads diverge in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by. He says that he has chosen the road that is not being used much by the people, and that has made all the difference. He says that he has chosen the road, the career that is not being used much by the people, so he's traveled on that, and you may say that he has been a bit of success with that. Again, the message of the poem, my dear student, is that whatever Robert Frost is saying, you should be very precise, ponder, think over it again. Whatever you are wanting to choose, whatever things you want, that you want, whatever you wanted to become in the future, you should be very, very precise with it. Okay, think and ponder and look as far as you can. Talk to the people, discuss, and then once you've decided with the road, with the career, with the life, and then it will not be possible for you to come back again and then to travel on the another road. I hope you have understood the poem. If any problem, please you can ask me, or you can write down your comments, and then please share our channel, that is Sony International School, and please press the bell icon. Okay, thank you, have a great day.